We're here with Trinidad and Tobago midfielder Kevin Molino. Kevin, what does it mean for you to be back into the national team after a lengthy layoff, your second major injury in your career, surgery to get it recovered, back into the Columbus Crew team and now back representing your national team? What was that like for you?
First, it's always a pleasure to represent my country at the highest level, and it's an honor. You know, I've been out for quite a long time, 3 years missed national team, and now I'm back. I'm excited, unfortunate with the results, but here we go again this week.
Obviously, the bigger picture for you is being able to defy the odds and enter international football once again, not just as a professional player in American Major League Soccer, but also being able to play on the world stage. You still have ambitions to possibly play at another Gold Cup. Of course, World Cup 2026 is right there. It's around the corner. Before you know it, we're going to be entering qualifiers again. This must be in the back of your mind. Tell us about that.
Yeah, first, I feel good. You know, good to go, continue playing with the national team. I have a lot of goals, especially individually and also collectively with the national team and also club-wise. But now my focus is here. I'm here. I want to win titles. I want us to qualify for the Gold Cup and see where it takes us. But more important is to mold the younger players, how much I can help them through their career, you know. And this is the role I want to pick up now, to more help the players and also be a leader and a big part of the team.
We're here in Thailand, Chiang Mai, thousands of miles away from the US and from Trinidad and Tobago. You know, this is all part of the process. We're going to come here, results are not always going to go away, conditions are always going to be challenging, but this is part of the journey again towards that bigger picture, which is trying to get ourselves back on top of you know, top tier in CONCACAF football and getting ourselves ready for Nations League qualifiers, which resume in March. How do you feel about it?
Yeah, I feel great. The condition is very difficult to play in, but this is part of the game, you know, to play in difficult places and try to get results. You know, unfortunately, we didn't get the results, but here we go again. It's a preparation for coming up in the games in Nation League. We're looking forward to that, and we just want to continue. And the last game on Sunday, try to get results.
What was it like for you the last 6 to 8 months? I mean, you know, from the moment you got that injury, I'm sure you would have had flashes of what took place prior to that in the previous injury. And did you question yourself and your ability to come back again?
Yeah, no, I never questioned myself with anything. I believe I come from humble beginnings, so I know what it is feel to go through a lot of pain, you know, and I've been through a lot with my injuries and in life, you know, and I just rebound and work hard and have the right mindset and keep God close and a lot of good friends and a lot of a good coaching staff to get me through this. And I'm just happy to be back to represent my country again.
Coming off your first goal for the season for Columbus Crew just a week ago, how did that feel and what's it been like in the Columbus Crew setup for you, especially coming off that injury and getting yourself back into the fray?
Yeah, first coming back, I feel great. I didn't get a couple minutes, but I now starting to get minutes. I now starting to feel like myself, you know, but bit by bit, I will get it going. And this is the point in time in my career that I expel and go good. The late end of the season going into playoffs. So I just want to continue building. And here is also a stepping stone to continue that and try to get a result Sunday.
Let's go back to the first game against Tajikistan yesterday. You know, we had a good start in the first half. We looked like a unit, even though this team has not really been together for long periods. How you felt about, you know, what took place in the game? Not a good second half, but how do you sum it off?
Yeah, a lot of guys, first time they play together, the chemistry gonna be hard. But when you look at the first half, you could see a lot of spurts that we did really well, a good build-up play, but a couple times we didn't finish our chances. And when you look at the second half, is lack of concentration, and we need to finish off games, you know, and we need to learn at times to win game 1-0. But so be it, we go, as a footballer, you always have a second chance, and we have a second chance tomorrow to try to get it right, to end the tournament on the right note.
Generally for you, when you look at what is happening with this national team, we have the challenges in football in Trinidad and Tobago that are ongoing. We are trying to fix things. It's not going to come across easy. It's not going to come easy. Well, when you look at what is happening here with this group and the way Eve and his staff are trying to put things in place, how do you feel about it? Because you come from an environment where you're accustomed to a level of professionalism at your clubs in the MLS. You've been on previous national teams where, you know, we've reached a certain level. We've reached the two quarterfinals in Gold Cup as well. How do you compare that as to what you're seeing here? And do you feel optimistic about what you're seeing, not just from a preparation standpoint, but in terms of the group of players that we have?
No, when you talk about the football standpoint, I think we have a great bunch of guys, a lot of young, talented players playing outside. But when you look at the next side of the other side of things, it's difficult to swallow some of the things. I think some of these players deserve better treatment. But the most important, all we have to do now is just play football and hope we can change things on the field.
In terms of how Eve is handling the team, working with the resources that he has, limited time, has that impressed you, or has that encouraged you to want to be part of this?
Yeah, definitely. I want to be part of this until my wheel fall off. And not just Eve, but the whole staff. Each and everyone get along good and respect the players and show them love and care. And information sake, when we go into a game, we get the necessary information that we needed to play against the opponent. And they've been doing a fantastic job. Just sometimes, unfortunate, we don't get the results that require that the work they are doing. But yeah, we just need to go and keep fighting for them.
What do you make of our chances against the host Thailand? We were hoping to meet them in the final, but we were meeting in the third place. But it's a good opportunity to play against the host country on Sunday. How you look forward to that game?
First, I think it's going to be a better showing because we spend more time in Thailand and we get accustomed to the weather. Coming 2 days and playing a game is difficult. The humidity was very difficult. And playing against Thailand, this game going to be a good challenge because this is a game we wanted to play. And we've been here spending time. We get accustomed to the weather a little bit. We'll be up for the challenge on Sunday.
Kevin, always good talking to you. All the best to you. And we want to wish you the best in the remainder of your season in the MLS.
Thank you.